time to introduce the next speaker in the hall. We have Geeyavudeen Musthafa. He's been the manager of technology at Sapient Global Markets. He has over 12 years of experience in IT consulting and services, mostly catering to the financial services industry. He specializes in enterprise application architecture, agile development, and Java JEE based application development. So please put your hands together for Geeyavudeen Musthafa for proactive application development, React in JavaScript.
Thank you. Probably I was the only one here. Okay, so thanks for the nice introduction. I'm here to talk about proactive application development with reactions. So, you might have heard about reactive program, right? What is proactive application development? I'm not going to talk about it. I'm sure like at the end of this presentation, you will be able to unbox the presentation right away. So before I get started, how many of you are already using ReactJS based technology stack? Okay, so maybe I won't be talking anything new for you guys. Most probably some of the things which I'm going to speak, you might already be using that. Okay, so before I get started, let me start the discussion with a small story. A small startup company came up with a unique idea of simplifying digital payments. Payment through mobile, otherwise called as mobile payments or digital wallets. Now they are one of the market leaders in the mobile digital industry, mobile digital payment industry. That the company is none other than Geeyavudeen. So we had financial giants like ICICI Bank and SBI. Who could have done that, right? But a technology company we came up with an idea and spread their business from there. So this is one of the quote of a famous CEO of a leading bank in US. According to PwC analysis, around 23% of financial services business could be at risk due to financial technology or fintech companies by 2020. So banks were traditionally very apprehensive on adopting technology changes. So if you have worked with any of the financial services clients, you would have experienced that, right? So they are in old age actually, So, but now the time has changed and even the banks are expected to invest into digital transformation and digital innovation. Okay, so these are some of the prominent faces in Sapient Global Markets. So if you connect the theme of our leaders' thoughts on digital transformation, one thing which is very evident is customer experience. The digital channels like web and mobile play an important role in strengthening the engagement of always-on customers. The digital is no longer merely one of the many channels, but it is the platform to empower people and deliver customer experiences that help grow business. Okay, so Sapient Global Markets being one of the leading the consulting firm, so we partner with clients from financial services and commodities market and help them build their brand and extend their business. So this is a typical scene in our organization. We get different requirements from different business units, from different geographies. All these can bring in unique synergies which can be combined together to create a powerful community that can help solve similar problems, right? But at the same time, all these engagements can have one way or other have some level of duplication if they are executed independently. That is when we thought we wanted to have some common ground of shared experience. So we have come up with something called Sapient Web Accelerator with ReactJS as the medium, which helps to fast track web application development project and helps smoothen the transformation of the journey. Okay, so let's build an app. Sorry to disappoint you guys, we are not going to build an app. Vibrant team is going to build an app. We are just going to overhear the conversation of that team. I know eavesdropping is bad, but let's do it personally, right? Okay, so in a nutshell, what these guys are trying to build? So they are trying to build an application for investment managers called IM Desktop. As part of the application, they are planning to build a dashboard of managed services, a fund performance page with some charts and analytics, and that likewise as dashboards for making investment decisions, and also they want to integrate with existing driving platform. Their primary focus is to build a desktop-based application, but they would want this application to be available even on web and mobile for the investment managers to make decisions on it. Okay, so here's the conversation between a UX designer and a web developer. So the UX designer has designed the components in an output for the application. But the challenge here is he has to wait for a long time to see them alive, right? So it is new normal to expect faster feedback in this agile world, isn't it? So here's when the interactive output comes in handy. With the help of interactive output, we can develop, design, test and style the components in isolation. Apps can be built, apps can be composed from these components. So we can see the transformation of the states alive. In the process, we can discover more states. And also we get instant immediate feedback as the changes are going to be available immediately, like when they are made. So we use React Storybook to achieve this. Okay, so a conversation between an architect and a web developer. By the way, that's not me. That's not Sundar Pichai either. The main concern of any architect is architecture and design. So component-based design is our primary design approach. So we follow pure UI paradigm where we build these components as a stateless pure function which does not retain any state. We also want those components to be as granular as possible so that it can be reused across the app, across multiple apps, even across multiple platforms. And that helps in omnichannel consolidation. So we also follow simplified architecture, Elm architecture, with the single state atom, where the entire state of the application is stored in a single JSON object. Use functional updates to update the state and provide it with the current state and an action is going to result in a new state. And we use functional views. Views are nothing but just a representation of the current application state. Obviously, like we use React and Redux to achieve this architecture and design. Okay, so here the business analyst wants some industry-specific components like a trade plotter and live prices dashboard for IM desktop, and she wants it immediately. I know she is more demanding, but it's a little exaggerated for us. So we have something called sapient components library, like where we have built industry-specific components. Components more specific to financial services in the commodities market, which can be directly plug and play into the application. You can compose the apps from these components. Okay, refine developer experience, the conversation between an architect and a developer. So today's technology is tomorrow's transform. Like the amount of changes that is happening in the JavaScript, it's always better to start any new application development with the latest version. So ES6 is our preferred version. So anyway, we are using Webpack for our bundler. So we can use Webpack dev server along with the React part module for hot loading the changes during debugging. And which also helps with time travel debugging if you want to traverse through the states like during debugging. So JavaScript used to be a less disciplined technology stream over a period of years, right? So I was part of a web application development project a couple of years back, which uses jQuery in the UI and Java in the backend. We conveniently ignored writing unit tests for the JavaScript layer and database layer. So we were anyway the quality metrics like code coverage and technical tests are captured only for the Java layer. Why to worry about JavaScript layer? But the industry has matured enough, like we have enough tools and technologies. Now we can follow core engineering principles even in the JavaScript. So I know JavaScript is a less typed language, but it is better to have some level of typing so that we will have better maintainability and code stability. Flow is another tool which helps for type checking. Obviously, having a common, consistent and clean coding principles, design guidelines, and quality mindset are must for any successful execution of this project, any project. Right? So with all this setup, you will feel like coding in a beach. Okay, so one more conversation between an architect and a web developer. have not planned it, guys, like just because I have played both the roles. I believe like these guys, they interact a lot, like at least during the initial phase of the project. Unit test. So how many of you love unit test? Okay, so how many of you actually does that? And okay, as Venkat said in the keynote session today, right? So unit test is like an exercise. Everybody loves it, but nobody wants it right now. Right? It's like having vegetables or like it's like your New Year resolution. However, without this safety net of unit test, like we can't move far or fast. You'll feel the pain like when you have to deliver the features. Right? So we use JEST. JEST is an easily configurable and unified framework which provides unit testing capability on code and components. Provides mocking the integration points, snapshot testing, and also it provides inbuilt tools like code coverage. So we also follow BDD best practices to unit test the components. As components exhibit the change in state or change in behavior, the enzyme is another utility library which helps to traverse through the components and unit test the hierarchy of the components. Okay, so here is the conversation to make QAs happy. Okay, so I'm not going to talk about like, I mean, the usual, the QA strategies like, I mean, integration tests, etc. So as I mentioned earlier, when our platform is a vehicle for delivering digital transformation, we need to keep accessibility in mind when our platform to reach experts. I knew a portfolio analyst who is very talented. But there was a hindrance in executing his job very effectively. He had a disability, he was colorblind. So imagine how important reds and greens for a portfolio analyst to rate and review and fund. Right? But even though like he has practiced the skill of identifying the colors based on its shades, it was not bulletproof. So how could it have helped if the application has provided accessibility to the remaining 15% of the population? So Vishadi from Sapient is going to talk about accessibility, like it's going to happen next session in our call. And also Dinesh is going to talk about the architecture part of accessibility, like as part of JavaOps and architecture, the same thing. In our framework, we use PaDI or PL11Y, which is a tool like I mean to validate the accessibility as part of our CI/CD pipeline. So most of our apps in the financial services industry are like, I mean, incentive applications, right? So which means like every performance issue costs products. So we use tools like PuffJanky and Joule to do performance testing and memory leak tests, not only on the code and components which we have developed, but also on the libraries which we use as part of our application. Okay, so here is the conversation to make how to make a painless deployment process. DevOps. DevOps is another buzzword in this ever-changing tech world, isn't it? But I believe now DevOps has, I mean, moved from the buzzword phase and have truly entered into everyday activity of an average developer. DevOps is an integrated part of any software lifecycle methodology. Now, every build can have its own slice of cloud nowadays, right? So we are moving towards a world where we want everything as a service and everything as code. So we built DevOps as a service using pipeline as code, using GitLab pipeline, like which provides inbuilt continuous integration, continuous deployment, and continuous delivery support to build, test, and deploy the application. We also use tools like Docker to create portable containers of our applications, and Rancher is another popular tool, like I mean, which helps, which provides a container management service and manage. Obviously, like npm script is our the task level step to execute the DevOps pipeline. Okay, so that's a roller coaster ride of lots of information. So I know there are lots of prerequisites to build an application using a modern JavaScript framework. So imagine how long it would take to wire up all the disparate tools and libraries to spin up a project. So thankfully, like, we have Sapien Web Accelerator, which provides which actually proactively bundles up all the tools and libraries that is required for faster development. So how many of you, I mean, can anyone tell, like, the scene from a movie? This
forest.
So similar to that one, right? So the accelerator framework helps to break the braces, which actually, like, I mean, which pulls you down from faster development. So it provides a boilerplate code, like, from the setup to production, right? You even provides a structure, like, I mean, which helps for multi-platform development. So it automatically creates the project structure using React and Redux for the web, and React Native and Godot for mobile, and Electron for the desktop application. It comes up with a Sapien component library where, like, we have industry specific components built on it. So we have lots of obviously, like, DevOps as a service is one of the important part, like, inbuilt as part of this framework. And obviously, like, we have a lot of references, design guidelines and design patterns available as part of these frameworks, like, which helps for organizational scalability. And we get help from the experts, right? So this is a summary of, like, what I have spoken, right? So the accelerator framework, it helps in all the phases of a software development life cycle, from setup, design, develop, test, and deploy. So with this, we are coming to the end of this. So we have opened up for any Q&A. Any questions, like, before I have some demo, like, I mean, about how the reaction would work. Before that, if you have any questions, like, you can.
It was really nice hearing to you. Thanks a lot. Thank you, audience.